So hi everyone, in the last session on Packet Tracer, I showed you how to connect two different networks using one single switch. And we figured out that when the packets from one network arrive at the switch has a very simple way of figuring out that it is destined for another network and it will directly do the routing. The routing tables need a setup when the routers come in different networks. So to save time, what I have done, I have already created this particular network, and all I am going to do is explore the setup. We have already seen most of the menu options and configuration screens that we use, so I hope you will be very easily able to relate with what I am saying. Now have a look at this diagram. You can see in this diagram that there is a router 0, there is a router 1, and there is a router 2 here, and they all the three are connected to each other. At the same time, router 0, as you can see here, is connecting this network, that is 10.1.11 network, and 10.1.13 network, that is this network. So router 0 is serving these two networks directly. Similarly, router 1 is serving a 192.168.5 24-bit network, and also 192.168.16-bit network, while router 2 is serving the 10-20 and 10-21 network. Now the question is, how do we make now the networks talk to each other? Drawing on the conclusions drawn in the last session on Packet Tracer, I'm sure now you can understand that these computers can directly talk to each other because they are connected through a router. These four computers in the 10-2 network, they can talk to each other because they are connected through a router directly, and these can talk to each other directly. Just to make sure, let us now go to this machine and let me go to the command prompt. Alright, so this machine is 10-2-21-10. So I have written a label here to indicate the configuration of this machine. So let me try pinging 10-2-21-10, that is the machine itself, ping is working. Let me try pinging 10-2-21-1, that is the router gateway interface, that is getting ping. And now let me ping another machine in another network, that is 10-2-26, and that should also work. It is through the same router. Okay, initial request may timeout for other reasons, so it is working. Now what we want is the machines in every network to be able to connect with every other machine. So all machines connecting to each other. That means now these three routers, they should be able to route traffic coming from their own directly connected networks to indirectly connected networks. And in this particular session, we are going to learn how to do the static routing setup. Now in static routing, we are not going to use any algorithms, but we will directly tell the router, because we know the network topology, using our human intelligence, not only routing algorithm intelligence, we will tell the router how to route the traffic. And I'm just going to show you the screen now. So click on the router, go to the config of the router. See, I'm in router 0 right now, and go to routing static. Now here you will see, I have already configured the static routes, and there are 4 routes configured here. So what do you say here? First it says 10-2-20-0/24, so that is the network 10-2-20-0. 24 bit means here you specify network mask. Yes?
Sir, the terminal is not visible.
Oh, right, I got it. Because the pop-up box is not visible, correct? Give me a second, I will make it visible. Stop the sharing. Share. Okay. I hope you can see it now.
Yes, sir.
So now, in order to route the traffic from this router that is coming from these machines or anywhere for this network, we have to tell this router that the traffic which is intended for the network 10 to 20 or 10 to 21 should actually be sent on this wire, isn't it? It should be sent actually to this interface, that is 10.105. Now please note that the routers are connected through fiber cable here, and as we have already seen how subnets get formed, this wire itself is one subnet, this wire is one subnet, and this wire is also one subnet. And you will notice now that the IP addresses I have assigned in the router to this and this interface, they are part of one subnet. Which subnet? This is 10.100 and this is also 10.100 subnet. Similarly, this is 10.101 and this is also 10.101 IP address, as you can see. While this subnet is the 10.102 subnet. So this IP address is 10.1026 and this IP address is 10.1025 IP address. Let me go to the router configuration. All we have to do is make entries in the static routing table. Before I go there, let me just show you this. The fast 600 interface is 10.111. That is this address, as you can see here. And okay, let me skip this. 10.111, that is the gateway of one network. The fast Ethernet 10 is 10.131, that is this address, as you can see. Now let me go, I have not used the serial interfaces. I will advise you also not to use serial interfaces. What I did is in every router I added a extra part to get two more LAN interfaces, Ethernet interfaces. Now you can see that one of these interfaces I have made 10.104, that is this IP address, and the other interface I have called 10.104, that is this 10.104, this one. So like this, in every router I have added a extra card with two LAN ports and configuring. Now, okay, once again in router 0. Go to static routing and now I have to add entries. So what I want to do is, I want to tell this router, the router 0, that if there is a traffic for 10.2.20 network, 10.2.20 network, that is 20.0, and the net mask obviously is 24 bit, that is how you call it a 10.2.20 network, then the next hop, see the first hop is the router itself, because the traffic has come to the router. Now I am telling the router that we redirect the traffic to 10.105. 105 is this IP. As you can see, sorry. 100 after this IP. I am saying this particular IP address should be your next hop. And I am just saying add that entry. Now you can see here, entries are already added here. I have added 4 entries. What are the entries saying? 10.2.20 network is via 100.5. So this is 10.2.20 network. This is reachable via 10.105. Similarly, 10.2.21 network is also reachable via the same. Now you can see the one below here is a 10.2.21 network. That is also reachable via this same interface. This is 10.2.20 network, 21 network, reachable via 10.100. Similarly, I am telling that the 192.168.5 network, that is this network, the network of these two computers, is reachable via 10.1.106, this one. As you can see here, 192.168.50 is via 10.1.106, and same is the case with 192.168.00 network, the 16-bit network, via this. So I have done this in router 4, I have added these 4 routes. Similarly, in router 1, let me go to the static IP routing here. You can see that I am saying 10.1.11.0 is reachable via 10.1.104. 10.1.11.0, that is this network, is reachable via 10.1.104. So, whatever traffic that is coming from this part, I am saying to this router that you send it to this IP as the next hop. And same is the case with 10.2.20.0 will also be sent to the 10 to 20 will be sent to this 1025, and 10120 10120 is this network, will also be sent to same next stop 102.5, and 13.0 will be sent to 101.4. So any traffic for this network will be sent to 101.4. Now I have shown you the configuration for two routers. I'm sure you can guess what is the configuration for this router too. With this setting now, let us go to any computer, and please trust me that I have configured the computers with the IP addresses that I have shown. I'm not going to repeat that exercise. You already know how to do that. So I am on this PC9, which is 192.168.10.9. So let me ping 192.168.10.9. That is itself. That is working. Then let me bring it here. And let me ping now another computer in the same network. That is 192.168.10.8. So the neighbor is, immediate switch neighbor is getting pinged. Let me try to ping 192.168.5.2. So that is through the router now, the first hop router, the gateway. The gateway is going to route the traffic. But as you can see, it is getting pinged. Now let me try pinging a computer in another network. But before that, I can also try this. So I am on this computer. Let me try pinging this IP address. So remember, all network interfaces of routers are pingable. And this IP address, and this IP address. I can ping even those. So ping to 10.1.102.6. Remember, this is the IP address of a gateway router. This IP address can be pinged even without doing any routing setup. Any static route is not needed to ping an IP address of an interface of your gateway router. So this 1.102.6 is pingable directly. But 10.1.102.5, that is the link to which 102.6 connects, is pingable only after you have done the routing setup. So this ping is working. Now let me try pinging 10.2.20.6. Now that is a network connected through two hops of routing. And you can see even that ping is working. Let me try pinging the computer in 11.4. So that is a computer in another router's network, router 0's network. And it should work 10.1.11.4. Yeah. So after two requests timed out, even that ping started working. So this is how you have to do router setup, so that static router setup, so that, you know, computers in different networks can connect to each other. Any questions? I'll take questions before I go further. Let me come to the assignment. So assignment of this week, this is assignment, it will be graded, is you have to set up this kind of network using packet tracer. Okay, this diagram suggests that the links between routers are serial links, but don't use serial links. Use Ethernet cables to connect the routers. We have to do this kind of setup. So you can see four switches and four routers. No switch is involved in this diagram. So you have to assign IP addresses and net mask to all PCs, all the router interfaces and so on. And you have to set up static routing so that every PC can ping every other PC. Once you do that, how do you submit? So if I try to save this, then you can see that it gets saved as a .pkt file. So you have to save it as a .pkt file and submit that .pkt file. But also you have to do this. There is this inspect button. So you click on inspect button, and then you click on say the router. Then it will say that I can show all these things, the routing table, IPv6 routing table. So say routing table. So now you can see it is showing the routing table. And let me increase the size of this. So I can see the entire routing table here. as you can see, this routing table, the four direct links 10.1.11, 10.1.13, 10.1.100 and 10.1.101, they are directly connected networks of this router. So it is directly saying that the traffic will be routed on this interface. While for these four, I added a static route, so those are being shown. But 10.2.20, 10.1.100, 10 to 20 networks should be sent to 10.1.105 and so on. So that is the routing table for router 0. And similarly, if I click on this, then I can see the port status summary table of this computer, and it shows me that this particular computer is 10.1.11.4/24 and the gateway is 10.1.11.1. So take a snapshot of this. This is one snapshot. Like this, for every PC and router code, you have to take 4 snapshots and just submit that to me. That is what I expect you to do. So this is the assignment that you have to do. Any questions that you have? Please note that you submit some good diagrams or good images, because I will see the packet tracer file only if it is needed. I will evaluate you based on the diagrams only. The packet tracer file will be used only if I will suspect that you have done some kind of cheating. No questions? Okay, then you start doing the assignment.